In the previous video, we developed the aerodynamic center general relations following a methodology presented by Phillips, Alley, and Niewohner, and came up with this solution here for the aerodynamic center location. And I'm now going to walk through an alternate way to look at that, an alternate derivation that I think is perhaps a little bit more correct in the way to think about this. So in general, this is what we know about pitching moments on an airfoil. We know that the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center is equal to the pitching moment at the origin plus xac over c times the normal force minus yac times the axial force. This is simply statics. All we're doing is saying that the pitching moment at some location is related to the pitching moment at the origin, and the location of interest, the aerodynamic center, and it's related also to the normal and axial forces and the offsets, you know, in x and y of that point of interest. So let's just start there for a minute. Now, by definition, we know that the aerodynamic center, by definition, is that the change in the moment at the aerodynamic center with respect to alpha is equal to zero. This is the definition of the aerodynamic center. Okay, now in general, the aerodynamic center is not necessarily a single point on an airfoil. It can actually change as a function of angle of attack. And so we need to first acknowledge that xac over c, if we look at the non-dimensional form of it, is a function of angle of attack, and so is yac. So so both of those in general can be a function of angle of attack. And there have been studies out there to prove that the aerodynamic center can shift slightly on an airfoil as you change angle of attack. So we need to just start out with these assumptions or this generalization. And so now let's look at the first derivative. We're going to try to apply this first requirement over here. We're going to try to apply that to this equation. So let's just take the first derivative of this equation here with respect to alpha. So we would get the change in CMAC with respect to alpha is equal to, and I'm going to use a shorthand version again, so CM not alpha, so that's a comma alpha, that means the first derivative with respect to alpha, plus, now if the aerodynamic center, the x and y locations can in general be functions of alpha, which is generally accepted, then we've got to retain the derivatives of those with respect to alpha. So so this is going to be xac of alpha over c. We take the derivative of the first times the second times cn plus xac over c times cn alpha. And then we can use the chain rule again on the last term. So this is going to be yac with respect to alpha over c times ca minus yac over c times ca comma alpha. Okay. So so we see we're in a bit of a mess here because we're trying to find the locations xac and yac. So we're trying to find these two terms that satisfy this. And of course, we know that the result of this equation has to be equal to zero because this is our, by definition, the derivative, the first derivative of the pitching moment at the aerodynamic center with respect to alpha is zero. So we can set this equal to zero, but it depends now on some terms that we don't know. So for example, it depends on the first derivative of xac with respect to alpha. So we can say now, well, we're going to constrain that. So this is exactly the logic that Phillips and Alley and Niewohner used. But they said, okay, we're going to say that xac with respect to alpha and yac with respect to alpha are both zero. Okay, so that's our next set of conditions. that we have to satisfy. And so so we can also do the same thing, and I'm just going to say, okay, so we're going to say that that is zero, and that is also zero. And of course, this is zero by definition as well. So so now this gives us the equation for a line, which is the exact same equation for the line that that Phillips and Allie come up and Niewoehner come up with originally. Okay, so this is the first line that we are going to satisfy. Now let's look. So what they do next is they take another derivative of this equation in order to find the second line, and it's the intersection of those two lines. If I scroll back up here, see what they did then. So this is the first equation that they came up with that we just rederived. And then what they do is take the derivative of that again in order to come up with this equation, which is also the equation of a line, and they apply this set of constraints here that the first derivative of x and y with respect to alpha are zero. Okay, so we can do that, but the problem with doing that after we have the problem of doing that after we have already crossed these out is that by taking the derivative of this equation now, after we've crossed these out, we neglect actually second derivatives. So really what we should do is take the derivative of this equation before we cross anything out. We should take the derivative of that again with respect to alpha and then cross out things. We're neglecting information if we first cross out these first derivatives and then take the derivative of this equation with respect to alpha again. We're neglecting the second derivative content in that equation. So let's take the second derivative now of this original equation with respect to alpha before we get rid of anything. So so this is now the first derivative, and let me just get rid of these guys here. So that's the first derivative. Now let's take the second derivative by taking again the derivative of this second equation. So what we'll get is that and we'll use shorthand again here. So we'll get the second derivative of the aerodynamic center with respect to alpha is equal to Cm0 alpha alpha plus, and now I need to do chain rule on this term. So I'm going to get the second derivative times Cn plus xac with respect to alpha over c times Cn alpha. So that was chain rule on this term here. Now we'll do the chain rule on this term here, plus xac alpha over c times Cn alpha plus, let's see, xac over c Cn alpha alpha. Okay, so I've done chain rule now on these two terms, and now on the next line I'm going to do the chain rule on these final two terms here. So we'll have minus YAC alpha alpha over C times CA minus YAC alpha over C CA alpha, and then minus YAC alpha over C times CA alpha minus YAC over C CA alpha alpha. Okay, so this is now our general equation using the second derivative with respect to angle of attack of this first equation, which is just the equation of our pitching moment on an airfoil. So that came from statics. This equation here in the middle is the first derivative of that with respect to alpha. And then this is from statics. This is our first derivative here. And this is our second derivative with respect to alpha. Okay, so in order to find a single point, in order to make each of these equations, the first and the second derivative equations, lines, we actually have to not only apply this this constraint here, that xac with respect to alpha and yac are with respect to are zero. So that knocked out in the first equation the terms marked in blue there, and we can knock out these terms here, these first derivative terms. So those are now knocked out. But in order for us to be able to solve this second equation and make it into equation of the line, we actually have to also assume that the second derivative of the aerodynamic center with respect to alpha, so this guy right here, and the second derivative of x and the second derivative of y all are zero. We have to do that in order to be able to get rid of these terms here. So we need that term to go to zero. We need this to go to zero, that to go to zero. And I think that's it, okay? So when we do that, if we apply this second set of constraints, which Phillips and Niewoehner and Alley do not mention, by applying those, now we come up with the exact same solution. We have two equations, equation one, equation two here. We have two equations that are each the equation of a line, and we can set those, we can find the point where those intersect, and actually it will become, you actually get the exact same solution as what we developed up here. So I won't rewrite that, it's the exact same solution. But in order to get that, we actually had to assume this set of constraints to find the aerodynamic center, which includes these constraints here in blue that have not been mentioned previously. And so this, in my opinion, this is the more correct way to develop this location of the aerodynamic center, that not only the first derivative with respect to alpha for the pitching moment, x and y locations, but also the second derivatives of each of those are also zero. And by doing that, you come up with these two equations, and we can now solve for xac and yac from these two equations. And we get this exact same solution. So this is an alternate way of looking at it. In my opinion, it's more correct. You can draw your own conclusion, and you can go back and look at the papers that have been published on this and decide for yourself what you think.